Welcome to Football Miami TV. This is Ed Serrano, also known as Uncle Ed, and here we are with a new section of our show called FMTV Cribs. And today we're going to start with Fernando Fiore, also known as El Presidente. He's going to show us not just his house, but he's got a big collection of jerseys, of soccer jerseys.
Vamos que te muestro las camisas. I'm gonna show you all my collection. Porque estás hablando mucho.
Sí, pero yo sé. Y después se van a aburrir con todo lo que yo hablo y no vale la pena.
Okay, Ed, I'm gonna interview you.
No, actually, yeah. Well, why not? The idea, yeah, we wanted to see all your collection, and you said how many jerseys?
Well, there is, I didn't have a specific count or the grand number, but I know that I have more than 400 jerseys. I divided them. Some of them are signed autograph, which is about, I would say, over 100. And that is because I started late to do that. In the beginning, when I started my collection back in 1999, I didn't want anybody to sign it because I wanted to use them. I wanted to wear them. So I said, I don't want to wear, you know, a jersey that is with a sign in the middle. Because, you know, at that time, you know, I was 39 years old and I was going everywhere with jerseys and not only to play soccer, but pretty much everywhere. So I didn't want to have them, you know, sign everywhere. But then, you know, like 10 years later, 15 years later, yeah, I would say 10 years later, I said, well, now I would like to have something special signed by the people who gave it to me, because, you know, there were so many that they have a lot of meaningful anecdotes. So I started to get all the jerseys signed. And some of them, the old ones, I started to look for the person again to make them sign it for me.
Hey, come on, now you can sign it.
Right.
So tell us about a few of these.
Well, this one, I put this one in the top because this is probably one of the mi más querida de todas. Porque no solamente es un jersey que es muy, muy antiguo, sino porque además es de mi gran ídolo, que es Ubaldo Matildo Filiol.
Wow.
El Pato Filiol. This is the jerseys that the goalkeeper from Argentina in 1978 World Cup. He was also the keeper in 74. He played one game in Germany, and then he played in 1982. And also he was in the qualifiers for 1986. He's my idol all the time because I was a goalkeeper when I was a kid.
Oh, okay.
And this was his jersey when he used to play in my team. In River Plate, and this one I have to say, he didn't give it to me. I bought this one, one of the few that I bought, and this because I was using this when I was a kid. I used to play with this particular jersey, and it's in,
you know, it's been worn.
Yeah, it's been worn, but it's in a perfect condition. And then when I met him many years later, he signed it for me. So. This is probably one of the jerseys that I, yeah, even though it's not a, he didn't wear this, but it's an original one that I bought in Argentina back in the 70s. And this is another River Plate one. This one is signed by Fernando Cabenagui. Sí, uno de los, este es uno de los diseños de camiseta que es medio extraño de River, porque es con la franja muy cortita. Y esta la usé durante mucho tiempo, en realidad, para jugar y para ir... para ir con mis amigos.
Por si no saben, es fan de River Plate.
Oh, sí, I'm a big fan. Y después, después él me la firmó hace un tiempito, otra de River. Esta es muy importante, porque esta sí la usó, él y me la dio el equipment manager del Galaxy, y esta es de... David Beckham, el dueño de nuestro equipo, del Inter. Sí,
he used
this one. Y me acuerdo muy bien el partido, porque este fue un partido contra Pachuca de México en un torneo internacional. Y en ese partido él salió lesionado. En ese partido él se hizo una barrida, que no tenía necesidad, David Beckham, de hacer una barrida. Y lo más interesante es que tenía todo el... toda la marca del de verde del césped aquí, pero después en vez de guardarla así, la lavé. Pero yeah, I washed it. Hubiera sido mejor guardarla con la marca del pasto. Claro. He was in that particular play, he was injured and he got out of the game. And Pachuca won that tournament. That was in the Home Depot Center back then, the home of the LA Galaxy. I saved it, they gave it to me. It was very precious, and then years later he signed it for me.
Nice.
So this
and
is.
You told him about that jersey? That
no, I didn't tell him yet.
He's gonna see the video.
Yeah, he's gonna see the video, and and he's gonna remember that game because it was one of the first games with the Galaxy. Imagine when David Beckham signed for the Galaxy, it was a huge news, and the MLS, you know, was in the eye of everyone around the world. And but then one of the few, the very first games, he got injured, and I said he got injured because he didn't need to do that play. He went all the way.
Who did he try to tackle?
He tried to tackle, I remember, Fernando El Pollo Salazar, a player from Pachuca. Actually, they both were kind of really banged, but I remember that David went out. This is more recent. This is from the past World Cup in Russia. And this is from the game Russia against Egypt. That was in 19 June. In St. Petersburg, and it was just brand new, and it was signed by every single player of the Russian team, and the people.
Putin's not there by any chance?
No, I don't think so. No, just the ones who play at the pitch.
Okay.
This is another one that I like very much. Obviously, the Red Bulls. Because we didn't have a team in the MLS in the beginning, and I used to live in New York, so New York, you know, it was my first team, and I was good, and then when we had the Fusion, then that's it. So now we are ready. This is now only Inter Miami. This is another very nice T-shirt. I like the design, I like the logo, I like everything. It's a Tampa Bay Mutiny, another team that disappeared along with the Fusion.
Yeah.
And this is signed by El Pibe Valderrama, who also played for the Fusion.
Yeah.
And I love this jersey. Like I said, I used to wear this jersey a lot.
Todo bien.
Sí, sí, yo la usé mucho esta jersey hasta que después, bueno, finalmente se la hice firmar y entonces ya no la usé más. This is another from the MLS, but this was a gift from Cuauhtémoc Blanco, the famous Mexican. El Cuau, cuando jugó en Chicago Fire.
La Cuautiña.
Cuautiña. And this is another. Oh, I have a good, you know, nice memories about this jersey. This is this one of the first jerseys that we have in República Deportiva. Irapuato is a team from Mexico, and they were going to the first division. And at that time, you know, it was really nice because our show, República Deportiva, back then, we were looking for good stories, for stories not only of the winners, but only the stories of the people who were working hard. And Irapuato, Los Freseros de Irapuato, that was one of those teams. And they were having a great team. I love the guys, were so funny. El Turco Mohamed was playing in that team at that time. I like them. I like them a lot, and we have plenty of those jerseys. There are many, many more.
You got more.
Yeah, if you want to go to my office.
Let's go check out the other jerseys. tons of jerseys. We've been here all day.
The ones in the office are also special because I frame them.
Right.
And those are the ones that probably I have closer to my heart.
Let's go check them out.
Pasa, que este es el santuario. No, acá sí que tengo las camisetas firmadas y enmarcadas, porque son las que obviamente tienen una relevancia mundial. Muchas de las que tengo, a lo mejor es gente que nunca escuchó hablar de un equipo de fútbol, de las camisetas que tengo en la colección. Pero estas ya es diferente. Acá todo el mundo escuchó hablar y vio la camiseta de Diego Armando Maradona, por ejemplo. Esta me la firmó Diego cuando nos encontramos en Alemania en el 2006, durante el Mundial. Me la encontró esta. Con Pelé tengo una relación muy cercana porque durante mucho tiempo estuvimos en muchos eventos juntos y tenemos amistades en común. Entonces él me firmó, me habían regalado una camiseta, esta no era de Pelé. Alguien me regaló una camiseta que decía Fiore y con el número 9. Entonces después él me puso para mi amigo Fiore Pelé y le puso la 10. La 10. Esta camiseta es una de las, posiblemente también de las más importante, el día que me decida venderlas. No, esta camiseta tiene mucho valor, porque esta camiseta está firmada por Alcides Guilla, que fue el jugador de la selección uruguaya, fallecido hace no mucho, el jugador de la selección uruguaya que silenció el Estadio Maracaná en el Campeonato Mundial de 1950.
Wow, esa sí es histórica.
Esa sí es histórica, porque esta es... aquel momento cuando todo el mundo creía que Brasil iba a salir campeón del mundo en 1950, maracanazo, el autor del gol, the second goal, fue Alcides Guilla, y después me la firmó también otro uruguayo que dio la vuelta al mundo, Enzo Francescoli, gran jugador. O sea que estas tres, y si hablamos de íconos, esta me la firmaron durante la despedida del Pibe Valderrama, cuando fuimos a ver su partido de despedida. El día anterior hubo una cena. Estaba Maradona, estaba Enzo Francescoli, acá estábamos con él. Esto fue durante varias visitas que él hizo al programa. Entonces ahí firmaron todos los que jugaron con el Pibe ese día, el Chonto Herrera, de esa generación dorada del fútbol colombiano. Asprilla.
De aquel que le metió los 5 goles.
¡Ey, ey, 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 ey!
Argentina. No me acuerdo muy bien.
Tarjeta roja para ti, déjame buscar dónde la tengo. Chilavert, otro grande de los grandes mundialistas, el arquero paraguayo cuando visitó la República Deportiva. This one also I like it a lot because Chilavert was one of the first big names that came to República Deportiva as a guest. He was one of the first big stars that he came to the show.
Was a personality.
Yeah, he was great. When we started this República Deportiva, the people were saying, "Oh, this is entertainment," and we wanted to do was sports entertainment, and that was our vision. And the people thought that we were crazy, that the show won't last, that how you dare to mix entertainment with sports? Sports is serious numbers, and we said, "No, sports is going to entertainment. The people want to be entertained." I don't want to say I told you so, but now everybody's doing entertainment, and it was the way to go. And Chilavert was the first one who was really big that came to the show. And then after that, there were so many huge stars that came to our show: Hugo Sánchez, Marcelo Gallardo, todos los jugadores de México que pasaron por ahí. Fuimos a visitar a Pelé. O sea, todo el mundo después quería venir. República Deportiva. Yeah, everybody wants to come and be there. That one I like. It was Diego Placente. I didn't make him sign. He used to play for River Plate, but then he went to Bayer Leverkusen. Another from River Plate. This one is very nice. Also again Enzo Francescoli, and this is the cover of a famous magazine around the world, El Gráfico. He's from Argentina, but he was red in all South America, and this was an amazing goal in the last second of the game. Yeah, it was a friendly match, but it was a 5-4, and it was in the very last second. He made an increíble chilena, y bueno, después de la misma, a bicycle kick, and then he signed it for me. Arriba está firmado el equipo de Argentina 2006, incluido Messi. No tengo una de Messi solo, tengo una con todo el equipo. Acá tengo una que a ti te va a gustar mucho, mi querido Ángel. Ecuador, un gran amigo, Alex Aguinaga.
The first World Cup.
It was, wow, man, that was something else. We were there in Ecuador. Arriba la despedida, el homenaje a Jorge Campos, Great game also. That was in Guadalajara. And I spent the whole weekend with them, all the players. His friends from different teams. He used to play in Pumas. He was playing Atlante. He came to the U.S. to play Fire, the Galaxy, well, national team. That one is very close to my heart too, because, and again, these are players from, some of them are players from 1950 World Cup. The famous 1950 USA team that beat England 1-0. You remember that one?
No, no.
Ah, you had a grandfather. You should remember. In 1950, they thought it was a mistake. They thought that England beat US 10-0. There was no social media, no, nothing. So the people thought that they said, oh, they made a mistake. It was England 10, US 1. And no, it was USA 1. The goal was made by Gagens. Christo Stoichkov, El Búlgaro, cuando nos visitó en República. Juan Pablo Ángel, esa fue una pretemporada del New York Red Bulls in Salzburg. That was a great time. Marcelo Gallardo, he played very little at DC United, here in the MLS, but, you know, it's one of my idols. Claudio Reyna, el Capitán América, el original, con los Red Bulls también cuando se retiró. El Diablo Echeverri, con el DC United, el boliviano, gran amigo también, además. He's a great guy. He went with us to play a friendly match, a celebrity match in Honduras to help kids from the foundation Amori Vida, very close to my heart. Chicago Fire, Samuel Caballero from Honduras. Oh, this is with Hugo Sanchez, Pumas, campeón back to back, de México, Barcelona on top. Champions League champions. That one was great also. Milan. Oh, that Barcelona, it was during a tour that they did here in the US, and I had a chance to be with all the players. We went to the NASA facilities. That was a great Milan champions, the UEFA Champions League 2007. I went to see the final in Greece with some friends from the Milan. Great team. Atlante, mi equipo en México, campeón también. Después fuimos al Mundial de Fútbol en Abu Dhabi. Pachuca, el equipo también más antiguo de México, campeón con Bucetich. Arriba otra. Ah, miren Guardiola, con cabello. No. Esa fue una gira que hizo el Barcelona por Estados Unidos en New York, y me tocó jugar con varios de los jugadores. Hicimos también unos partidos de 5v5 for charity, and I made an incredible goal. It was a pass from Puyol, and I made a fantastic goal. Nunca me voy a olvidar, un cabezazo, Puyol me la pasó y cabeceé. That was great. Sí, está Bojan, Dani Alves y Guardiola. Y acá una de Hernán Crespo del Milán, que esa me la trajo de regalo Fernando Clavijo, y después trabajé con Crespo durante el Mundial del 2018, de este año. El América, también campeón. Y esa is not a jersey, it's a t-shirt, but I love that t-shirt, because it was Atlante, campeón 2009 de la CONCACAF Champions League. Pedro Vilar, Pereira, el argentino Pereira, que también jugó en River, y esa copa le permitió al Atlante ir al Mundial de Fútbol de Clubes, algo impensado, porque Atlante ahora que está en segunda división, pero en el 2009 se ganó el campeonato, se ganó la Champions, y fuimos hasta Abu Dhabi. Yo fui con ellos al torneo. This is something very funny, because for some reason, a lot of broadcasters in Mexico are Atlante fans. A lot of them, and they always tweet. And a lot of the people who you see in Televisa and ESPN, they are Atlante fans. Y yo, que soy argentino y vivo en Miami, pero que escogí el Atlante porque me trataron con cariño, yo fui el único que fui hasta Abu Dhabi. Le digo, ustedes son mexicanos y siempre dicen que soy hincha de Atlas, pero yo no vi a ninguno de ustedes en las gradas en Abu Dhabi dándole con un bombo y enseñándole a todos los árabes cómo gritar potro, potro, para que alentaran al Atlante. Fue una experiencia muy linda. El Atlante le estaba ganando al Barcelona la semifinal. Barcelona había decidido guardar a algunos jugadores, entre ellos Messi, en la banca porque pensaron que el Atlante se lo iban a comer facilito, y resulta que el Atlante le iba ganando 1-0. Entonces en el segundo tiempo, bueno, pusieron a Messi y todos los Top Guns y lamentablemente perdimos la semifinal, y después fuimos al tercer puesto, que caímos por penales también. Y esa, que es la que cierra acá en mi oficina, esa es la que más me gusta, más de todas, porque con esa salí campeón yo. Con ese equipo de Univisión salimos campeones de un torneo que era de los medios de comunicación acá en Miami, y bueno, esa era nuestra camiseta. No la firmé porque, como era para mí, iba a quedar medio extraño que dijera tu Fernando Fiore. Sí, I don't know, it would be a little strange. Yeah. Con cariño para Fernando, de Fernando. Entonces, bueno, no la firmé, pero ahí está la foto. Ya eso tiene ya yo creo que más de 10 años fácil. Pero bueno, seguimos jugando ahí. Bueno, quiero mostrarte, mi querido Uncle Ed, dos camisetas muy importantes, que no solamente son importantes por el fútbol en este caso. Esta es mi camiseta de Special Olympics. El fútbol sirve también para ayudar. To help the people that they need us. And the Special Olympics, all those kids, they love to play soccer. They are really happy when we come up with the big stars from previous years, like Enrique Borja, Pavel Pardo, el Nene Cubillas. Y tuve la dicha de poder jugar un partido muy especial con Zico en las favelas de Río de Janeiro, en Brasil, para ayudar a los chicos de Special Olympics. Y eso fue un momento sensacional en Río de Janeiro. Así que esta es muy importante. Y como quiero que terminemos por el principio, te voy a mostrar la que fue mi primera camiseta de mi colección. O sea que, we finish with the beginning. Esta camiseta de Chivas fue mi primera camiseta de mi colección. Fue del año 1995, cuando estábamos haciendo el programa Fuera de Serie. ¿Te acuerdas? Con Sofía Vergara. ¿No te acuerdas? You don't remember me, but you remember Sofía Vergara from Modern Family now. Well, that was our very first show. Y fuimos a un partido de las Chivas en el Estadio Jalisco. Y me regalaron esta camiseta, y con esta comencé la colección, que ahora tiene más de 400 camisetas, más de 100 y pico firmadas. And it was a pleasure to share my collection with you, with your new segment for your show. And I hope that you have fun.
Thank you so much.
Here, te la regalo.
Fernando. The best way we could tell people now, tell them to follow you on social media.
Yeah, well, you can follow me in Instagram, Fiore Official, y en Twitter, Fernando Fiore. Así mismo, @FernandoFiore, @FernandoFiore. I also have the Facebook, but I use mostly Twitter and Instagram.
Excellent.
Okay.
All right, guys, thanks.
One more thing. Remember, I need my Inter Miami jersey.
Oh yeah, we're gonna see about that. Thanks so much, and we just want to say thank you, Fernando, once again. Remember to follow us, Football Miami. Goodbye to everybody.
Hey.